All right. Welcome back to episode 10 of What If Vader and Starkiller Killed Palpatine and Vader Ruled the Galaxy? And this is episode 10. You notice that we have a new thumbnail. Basically, what happened is I was doing a film for my theater class. We had a film festival, and I had to get rid of a bunch of stuff on my computer and phone, and I accidentally got rid of the original thumbnail, and I went to go get it back, and I was like, it was kind of boring, you know? It was just Vader and Galen, and there was a big no sign over Palpatine, and I decided to use a little bit of Photoshop, some really bad Photoshop, and create a new thumbnail, and I think it's pretty cool. You've got Vader and Galen, you know, they're the center of the story, they're dynamic, their rivalry, and then on the left side, we've got Maul and Luke, and then on the right, we have Ahsoka and Leia, who are also very integral parts of each of the stories, and then in the background on the top, we got Thrawn. You know, he isn't the main character of the story, but he's in the back, he's pulling his strings, so, yeah, I thought it was a cool picture. Maybe it would have made more sense to have Maul and Luke on the right, because with Vader, because of the dark side, and vice versa. Because of the light, but I don't know, I like it. I think it's pretty cool, but anyway, so we got episode 10. This episode is completely dedicated to the climactic, hopefully long-anticipated duel between Galen Merrick and Darth Vader. This fight has been built up to, and the entire episode is just a narrative telling of this climactic duel. Hopefully you've been waiting for this, because this is a huge moment in the series. As I've teased before, Vader is not Galen's endgame opponent, and who knows, maybe that endgame opponent will be revealed at the end of the episode as a cliffhanger. You never know. So you might just want to, you know, watch until the end. But yeah, I'm very excited to tell this duel. Yeah, let's get into it. We open right where we left off, with Galen Merrick staring down his former master, Darth Vader, on the planet of Kashyyyk, now ripped apart and destroyed by the Empire's attack on the planet. Quinlan Vos is still behind Merrick, still holding the lifeless bodies of his wife and son with tears, while Maris Brood stands beside the Galactic Emperor. It is as if time itself has paused, as Galen and Vader stare each other down, nothing but rage filling their minds. It is Vader who speaks first.
I gave you this world. I gave you power, a purpose in the galaxy. Everything you have ever have, you have been gifted by me, and you still chose to throw it away for this. Everything you gave me? Galen asks, rage now boiling within him. His fingers spark with electricity, born of hatred and darkness. You murdered my father, kidnapped me from my home, raised me to kill all your enemies, and tortured me when I failed even the slightest of moments. All you ever did was take my life away from me. And in return, you were given the ultimate power, second in command of the entire galaxy, and your full potential in the Force unlocked, Vader argues. Don't you get it, Master? I don't want the ultimate power. I wanted to have a life, a home, my family. Do you even know what it's like to lose all that? There's a tremor of darkness that comes from Vader. We see flashes of Anakin as a young boy, eating dinner with his mother, trying to find some love and joy in their rough lives. We see an older Anakin sharing a dance with Padme, on a break from the violent Clone Wars. We see him with Ahsoka and Obi-Wan sharing laughs and conversations before everything shifts. We see Shmi's death and the slaughter of the Sand People. We see Ahsoka leaving Anakin, abandoning him for her own selfishness. We see Padme collapsing unconscious on Mustafar, and we see Kenobi's death on Alderaan. We see the illusionary world that Vader had created within his own mind, desperate to hold on to the peace and love he had once held in his heart, as it tore away each time. Vader breaks out of his mind, fueled with pain and rage, as he turns to Maris Brood. You have served the Empire well. If you wish to become my new apprentice, then you have but one task. Kill Starkiller.
As you wish, my Emperor, Maris responds, as she ignites both of her lightsaber tonfas and charges right towards Merrick.
Suddenly, she finds herself frozen in midair as Galen holds out his hand before unleashing a massive bolt of force lightning and incinerating the fallen apprentice of Shakti into a smoldering corpse. Galen ignites his lightsaber and swings at Vader's head as the Dark Lord ducks under the strike and evades a second. As Galen moves in for the next attack, he is pushed back with the force as Vader ignites his own crimson blade. The two both move into their signature stances, Galen in his classic reverse grip, and Vader in his stance from the Cloud City duel in The Empire Strikes Back. Galen is the first to strike, as he unleashes a ferocious Juyo onslaught, unleashing his rage and desire to destroy the Dark Emperor against his greatest enemy. Vader fights with his powerful Degem So, blocking everything his apprentice brings and redirecting the power with his own counterattacks. Their blades flash a storm of bright blue and crimson red in a flurry of strikes that range from heavy power attacks to quick and rapid thrusts and parries. This is a battle unlike any other that Galen had seen in his life. Coda had certainly been a challenge, and he had not been entirely sure he would make it out alive against Shakti and Kenobi. But Vader was something entirely different. The sheer power unleashed through every attack, the way he had been able to use Galen's own strikes against him, the magnitude of his force attacks was unlike anything Merrick had ever faced before. This duel wasn't entirely a duel. It was not a contest of master and apprentice. It was not a duel to save the galaxy, nor a duel of the fates. This was pure rage. Two beings whose destinies were linked to each other, both broken by loss and tortured by power, unleashing all their rage against the other. For Galen, this is the man who stole his life away from him, to be used as a weapon. He had been taken from his home, all the memories he shared with his family, a distant memory that could never be restored, their laughs, their love, all gone and never to be replaced. Their memories were now replaced by brutal torture and training. The fear of never being good enough for Vader, the fear of not seeing another day for his failures, all colliding into this very moment. For once, he had been given a proper life with these Jedi. He had been given a home, only for Vader to burn it down. For Vader, this was the apprentice he had desired so much. He may have been brutal in his training, but deep down in the heart, a part of him had looked at Merrick like the son he had never had. The Emperor had instructed him to train Galen to hunt down the Empire's enemies for them, and Vader had rescued him from his troopers after sensing his promising connection to the Force. But through the dark training, Vader had seen something more in the child. A child to raise, and in the strange, twisted way of the dark side, have a son. He had nothing else left in the galaxy. And it was no matter how much he ruled, just for a moment he considered if he could have just one last chance. His training may have been brutal, but it had been because that was the way of the Sith. Vader had dreamed for so many nights of killing the Emperor, for his betrayal and his lies, and only with Starkiller they were capable of such a thing. Now the last thing he had even considered having in his life had abandoned him, just as everyone had abandoned him before. Now, there was truly nothing left for him. Only his rage. Only the dark side. The battle only grew more intense. They jumped onto trees, across broken down huts, across the fiery meadows and through foliage. They threw rocks and trees at each other through the force, and Galen unleashed barrages of force lightning that Vader blocked with two Tementis. They threw their lightsabers at each other, and used telekinesis to raise and fire the blasters of fallen troopers at each other. Their rage and their presence in the Force could be felt across the planet as a dark aura formed around them. Finally, Vader had enough, as he held out his hand and caught his apprentice in a violent Force grip. He threw Merrick into one of the burning huts before bringing it down upon him. He turned to where his apprentice had begun building his fortress on the planet. the tree where his family had grown up. Vader called upon his power, ripping the tree from its roots and tearing the fortress apart before pushing it down on top of the Jedi's hut. He considered killing Quinlan, but ultimately decided against it, since Voss no longer possessed enough of a threat. He moved back to his personal shuttle and began to fly towards the Super Star Destroyer. He had completed his mission here. With a jolt of rage and power, Galen unleashed a force repulse that blasted the hut and the fortress off of him as he got to his feet, noticing Vader leaving the fight behind. Galen ignited his lightsaber and chased after the departing shuttle. Using the force, he began to pull the shuttle back to the ground. Vader opened the back door to the shuttle and threw his lightsaber towards his apprentice, who deflected the attack. Not wasting any more time, Vader used the opening to throw a giant boulder at Merrick to keep him occupied even longer, giving the shuttle enough time to escape the rogue apprentice's grasp. Galen tried to pull the shuttle back to the ground, but it was too late now. Vader had escaped his clutches, and he got away with the deaths of so many Jedi. Galen saw his fortress, the place that had once been his home, now destroyed, and it only built up his rage further. From the corner of his eye, he noticed Leia and Ahsoka, who had been pinned down fighting the last of Vader's forces on the surface. They had seen Vader leave as well, and were devastated, hoping to have been able to confront him as well. Galen rushed towards them, and in a burst of power, channeled waves of force lightning that left all the poor victims a smoldering mess. Galen looked to the sky, seeing Vader's shuttle disappear into space as all his rage collected into one big burst. He began to levitate off the ground, and his eyes began to flicker from their normal color to a violent yellow. "Vader!" he screamed, his voice echoing through the Force so loud it could be heard across the planet, in space, above, and even Master Yoda could sense his rage, sighing with defeat, believing him to be lost to the dark as well. The ground underneath him began to rip apart, and several trees had been brought down by his sheer power and rage. Ahsoka moved over to Galen shortly and deactivated her lightsabers. "Galen?
And you actually wanted to try and save that monster?" Galen snapped back.
Ahsoka tried to come up with an answer, but ultimately stayed silent. Galen scoffs and walked away from the battlefield to collect himself, while Leia moves over to Quinlan Voss, placing a hand on his shoulder as the two mourn the loss together. We cut to Kamino, where we see Emperor Vader's personal shuttle arrive. As he exits, Vader is met by two Kaminoan scientists.
"My lord, it is good to see you. I am pleased to say that we have made incredible progress on the project."
"Have any of the clones survived the test?" Vader asks. We can tell that he is still fueled with irritation and rage from his previous duel.
One of the Kaminoans nods eagerly.
"Only one of them survived your test. He survived 13 days without food or water, and still remains capable of fighting our training droids."
"And he can wield the Force?"
"Just as good as the host."
Vader follows the Kaminoans into the lab before he is taken to a training room where we see the Starkiller clone from The Force Unleashed 2 facing off against at least four training droids. He's wielding two vibroblades rather than lightsabers, and we see him use the Force to crush one of the droids before throwing it into another. In a burst of strength, the clone unleashes a Force repulse, sending the other two droids back. Vader opens the door to the training room, followed by the Kaminoans. The Starkiller clone initially moves into an attack position, but stands down on the Kaminoans' orders.
"Does the clone have mental stability?" Vader asks.
"Although it was difficult, we managed to stabilize his mind."
Vader looks to the new clone, who instinctually bows.
"I am Lord Vader, Emperor of the Galaxy, Dark Lord of the Sith, and your new master."
"I am honored, master," the clone responds.
Vader motions for the scientists to leave them at once.
"At last, it is time to begin your training."
And that is where this part ends. Well, that was pretty intense, wasn't it? Yeah, so this entire episode was really focused on Galen and Vader. I mean, Ahsoka and Leia showed up for like 2 seconds in the story, but the whole episode was really based off of this climactic duel that I've been really hoping to get on screen. And we know who Galen's final opponent is. It's himself, or a clone of himself, but it's still cool. So I always wanted Vader to be like an endgame opponent, but one of the ideas I had was, I thought it was too obvious. It was too obvious to have Vader as the final boss. So Lumaya was already, I already put Lumaya in the story, so Vader isn't against having other apprentices in this universe. So I was like, hey, what about the Starkiller clone? Obviously things are different because, you know, Galen, the real Galen is still alive with the clone, but hey, it's fun. And I know Kamino was destroyed in the Bad Batch. Well, guess what? I don't like the Bad Batch, okay? All the Bad Batch does is retcon the superior stories, and so I'm gonna retcon the Bad Batch as payback. I'm sorry, I just really don't like the Bad Batch. I can go into like an hour-long podcast about why I don't like it, but we're not gonna get into that because that's not the focus of today's episode. So yeah, the next episode is gonna be more of the usual stuff. It'll be more, you know, switching between our different stories, between Galen, between the Jedi, Vader, Thrawn, Maul and Luke and their criminal escapades. So it'll be a little more of that next time. But I just wanted to dedicate an episode just to Galen and Vader and this duel that I've been wanting to tell for a while, because honestly, I think we have maybe 2 more episodes and then the finale. And the finale is going to be a big episode. The finale's, we're going to have 1 more episode and then we're going to have like a prelude to the finale, like a prequel, like a setup for the finale. And then we're going to have the finale, which is probably going to be over an hour long. I wouldn't be surprised if it's over an hour. So, because it's going to be huge. Because, I mean, think of all the stories we have to wrap up. And, hey, we aren't limited by time. Plus, don't you want as much of me in your life as possible? I'm kidding. Nobody wants me. But anyway, that's going to about do it. And I'll see you guys next time. Peace.